Good morning children, Sai Ram. So welcome back to your online teaching session after your unit test. Hope all have done well in your exams, right? So now let's get prepared for our next exam. So let's proceed with the syllabus. Yes, the next lessons in our syllabus. Today we'll be doing lesson number 7, Educating Mother by Sukandhi Krishnamachari. So this is the part 1 of our lesson. Now what are we going to learn in this lesson? In this lesson, we have a mother who tries to tell stories to her children. So as we proceed further, we will get to see how the children react to the stories. Now children, do you all like to listen to stories? Yes, of course, everybody likes, right? So we are used to listen to stories from our elders, our grandparents, our parents, right? And everybody loves, and especially bedtime stories are more interesting, right? When you have grandparents at home, and in the present situation, you all must be having this kind of experience in your house, right? So everybody in the house, the whole family, and then we try to share stories with each other, right? Now what do you think, children? Stories, are they fun? Yes, of course. Stories are not only fun, but they also provide us with lot of information, and also it is an interesting way to communicate. Yes, it helps us to talk to each other, communicate with each other, and also it tells makes us imagine, learn, dream, and remember certain things with the help of stories. Now, stories are the oldest form of art. Yes, storytelling is an art, and it is one of the oldest form of art. So you'll find that stories are found to be everywhere. You find stories in the books, in the newspapers, in televisions, internet, everywhere. Yes, so we have the habit of reading storybooks, right? Now, stories of what kind? Stories like animal tales, panchatantra, then fantasy, fairy tales, which take you to the world of fantasy, imagination. And we try imagining those characters or those things in the story as if it is actually happening, right? So we all are used to this kind of experiences. So this is what in the lesson we are going to learn. Now when we talk about storytelling, what are the things that make story a great, right? What are some of the qualities, some few qualities of stories? For example, the dramatic content, the content of the story. When it is dramatization is there, we feel more interesting because there are dialogues, there is conversation, and also memorable characters. There are certain characters in the story which leave an impact on our mind, right? And each part of the story, if it is effective, then we find the story to be more interesting. Also, dialogue, the conversation between the people, between the characters in the story, it makes the story more interesting. And the start, when you start with a great beginning, story should have a great beginning. When the beginning of the story is interesting, of course we are very much interested to know what is going to happen at the end. So we try to listen to the story till the end, and also be satisfying, so that whatever was the conclusion that was expected, we get out of the story. So these are some of the qualities a story should have. Like, it should have a dramatic content, memorable characters, each part of the story should be effective, dialogue, great beginnings, and satisfying endings. Now children, do you think stories help us to know more about people, their lives and experiences? How? Yes, of course, they tell us, right? When you read to certain stories, you also try to relate certain stories with our own experiences or with the experiences of other person, or sometimes with the experiences of the characters in the story, we learn some lessons from them, right? So in this way, stories prove to be very helpful in order to know people. Now let's start with the story. Before we start, we'll get introduced to the characters in the story. Now, who are the characters? One is the narrator herself, that is the author herself. She is telling the stories to her children. Then next we have the mother of the narrator. Then we have 6-year-old Janki, niece of the narrator. 12-year-old daughter of narrator is Ambu. Then we have Ramu, 4-year-old son of the narrator, and Venku, 3-year-old nephew of the narrator. So these are the characters in the story, right? Now, what should be a purpose of a storyteller? Now, the purpose of the storyteller is not only to tell you how to think, but to give you questions to think upon. So you learn from the story how to think, but at the same time you say there are various questions arising in your mind when you go through the story, when we listen to the story, right? Why this happened, how this happened, when this happened. So there are various questions coming into our mind as we read the story. Now, before we proceed, we'll just learn some new words, their meanings, and try to frame sentences. Squeaked, to make a short high-pitched sound. Squeaked means to make a high-pitched sound. The front door squeaked as it opened. The next word, strayed. Strayed means moved away from a familiar place. Tourists often get strayed into dangerous areas. Then we have the next word, macabre. Macabre means fearful. Police have made a macabre discovery. Next, indulgent means to allow someone to do or have what they want. So the sentence, my indulgent parents give me everything I want. Right? So now, let's start with the story. It all started when my mother asked me to tell the children a story. I cleared my throat and began. Long, long ago. How long ago? Squeaked my 3-year-old nephew Venku. Never mind, it was a long time ago. Let's get on with the story. Try telling my history teacher that, said my 12-year-old daughter Ambu. She insists that I get all the dates right in my history test. I decided to ignore her. There was this girl called Goldilocks. The names parents come up with, muttered Ambu. Thank God you didn't choose to call me Long Nose or Saucer Eyes. Goldilocks decided to go for a long walk. I continued. So here we can see children, mother is trying to tell stories to the children, and there are certain questions arising out of from the minds of the children. Like as she begins with the story, as the narrator's mother tells her that you should tell stories to your children. So she also tries and she begins with the story. So as she clears her throat and begins, long, long ago, immediately you'll find that the 3-year-old nephew of nephew Venku, he squeaked. How long ago? Means there should be particular time now. You can see her saying long, long ago means how long ago? So then she ignores. She says, come on, forget that. Never mind. It was a long time. But the children were small. She thought of explaining them in that way. Let's go on with the story. And she continues further. So immediately from the other side, we find that her 12-year-old daughter, Ambu, she says, try telling this to my history teacher. You know, children in history, we are asked to remember dates of certain events. And also the date should be correct according to the events. So that is what Ambu is telling her mother. Why don't you tell this to my history teacher to forget about the days? Event is mentioned now. So then, but she insists that the date should be correct. I decided to ignore her. So what the narrator does, she just ignores her. And then she begins with the story and she says that there was a girl called Goldilocks. Now see the name of the girl also, Goldilocks. So immediately the other, she, Ambu, starts muttering, what names the parents keep. And she thanks her mother, come on, you have not kept my name like Long Nose or Saucer Eyes. Goldilocks decided to go for a long walk. She continues with that. Okay, so let's see now further. what is the next question arising? Did she have a weight problem? Asked my 4-year-old son Ramu. No, she didn't. She went for a long walk and strayed into the forest. Soon she discovered that she was lost. If she would have had a cell phone, she could have called her mother, said my 6-year-old niece Janki. Don't be stupid. They had no cell phones in those days, said Ambu. So now here, when she is telling about Goldilocks that she had gone for a walk, immediately you'll find that the 4-year-old Ramu, what he says, did she have any weight problem? Normally we suggest people, na, if they have weight problem, why don't you go for a morning walk or evening walk? So accordingly he says, does she have any weight problem? So she was going for a walk. So then the mother says, no, she didn't have any such problem. And she went for a long walk and she strayed into the forest. Okay, she lost her way into the forest. Then immediately she is telling, Janki is telling, if she has lost her way, if she would have had her cell phone, she would have called her mother and told, na, if she has lost her way, please come and take her. So how silly, she was not having a cell phone. So then mother is telling, come on, don't be stupid. It was not that that time where there were no cell phones, okay, in those days. So who is telling this? Ambu is telling that don't be stupid, there were no cell phones at that time. It was that long time ago the story belongs to. Oh, so it was that long ago, exclaimed Janki, as if the pre-cell phone era belonged to the antediluvian days. So then the poor thing came to a cottage that belonged to the three bears. She was hungry, that she made straight for the dining room. There on a table were three cups of porridge. She made a sip from Father Bear's cup. It was too hot. Mother Bear's porridge was too cold. But the porridge in Baby Bear's cup was just right. So she drank the Baby Bear's porridge. Now here you see, she's telling that she was not having a cell phone, it was that long ago. So what is she saying? Oh, so it was not that long ago. Who is exclaiming like this? Janki. That it was that long ago, the story belongs to that period when there were no cell phones. So that means the story belongs to the pre-cell phone era. That means the antediluvian days. Now what do you mean by antediluvian days, children? It is a period of time that preceded the great flood of Noah. And you have the mention about this in the Bible. Okay? So the poor thing came to a cottage that belonged to the three bears. So this girl Goldilocks, as she lost her way and she walking, she came to a cottage. And that cottage belonged to the bears. She was so hungry. So as she entered into the cottage, she just straight away went to the dining room. There on a table were three cups of porridge. She had a sip from Father Bear's cup. So she had one sip from Father Bear's cup and she found that was too hot. Then she saw Mother Bear's porridge. It was too cold to drink. But the porridge in Baby Bear's cup was just right. So she drank the Baby Bear's porridge. So here we can see, children, that mother is trying to tell the story to the children and children are having such silly questions. They are trying to relate it with the actual life and they are questioning their mother about this and trying to they want her to answer, wherein the mother tries to ignore and she tries to proceed with the stories, but the children are not allowing her to proceed further. Now what happened in the story of Goldilocks further, we'll see in our next class. Okay, so we'll stop here for today. Thank you, children.